Daf Kuvav, page 106. Tanu Rabbanan, Zachor et Yom HaShabbat LeKadsho. 8 lines from the top of the page. Good morning. The Torah said, remember the Shabbat to sanctify it. So how you do that? Zochreu alayayin. And that's, soon you see, it's a lot of practical halachot. A person should remember by reciting the Kiddush over the wine. So it's mentioning is precisely Tosfot said by saying that. Ainli ela bayom. Now you see the difference. What's more important? The mitzvah of make the kiddush is in a day. Balayla minayin. How do you know it's applied to the night too? Because according to many rishonim, you see in Magen Avraham in 271, you see in Shagat Aryeh Bualacha and many. It's the hold the kiddush is in the world of the Friday night, even without wine. There are many hold, but during the day, everyone said it is rabbinic, and that's basically the Ran said it and the Ravid, Magid Mishneh and others. Ain li ela bayom balayla minayin. Tamud lomar zachor et yom haShabbat lekadesho. Soon we explain it. So he said, "Balayla minayin adraba ikar kiddusha balayla hu dechikadish trat yom abayla kiddushi." Think about it. Now we separate between Friday, secular day, and Shabbat. It's Friday night. You should make a kiddush. Zachor, you remember you mentioned that when it's sanctified lekadesho. That's the time. So that's the time. Vayera vayboker go by the night. Night's the night of Shabbat. So that should be the essence. Furthermore, the two. בלילה מנין תמול לומר זכור את יום, they said, remember that day, תנה מהדר הלילה. So the Tana tried to bring the souls for the night, וכנסו לקראת היממה. So he explained that the pasuk that said the day, the יום, החקי אמר, so they explained it. And they fixed that meaning. זכור את יום השבא לקדשו, זוכר על היין בכניסתו. You should mention that over the wine when it starts. And then he said, אין לי אלא בלילה. The mitzvah of making kiddush apply tonight. Bayom minayin. How do you know that's applied today? Talmud lomar zachor et yom haShabbat. You should remember the day of Shabbat. Bayom, meaning that you have to make the kiddush also during the day. Bayom mai mevarich. So, what type of bracha you should make during the day? Amar Rav Yehuda bore pri agafen. You bring a cup of wine before the suda. You make bore pri agafen. You drink it in honor of Shabbat. Even you don't mention the sanctification of Shabbat, but you show the honor of Shabbat by making the bracha of the wine before the meal, and by doing so, you separate between the Suda of Shabbat and the Suda of the week. It's like the blessing of the wine before the meal, it's considering, it's like praising and preparation of the beauty of Shabbat. So here the Gemara, as we did in the previous pages, bring a story to emphasize this point. Rav Ashi Ikla leMechoza. Rav Ashi came to a city called Mechoza. So when it's time of this Seuda begins, Amru le lekadesh lan mar kiddush haRabba, should make a big kiddush, Ahavu le, so they brought him a cup of wine. Savar mai niu kiddush haRabba, what does that mean when they use the term big, large kiddush? So does that mean long, or what exactly they meant? So they said, Amar, he said to himself, regardless if the people in Mechoza has a minag to say the day, the entire kiddush of the Friday night, or they do it just borei pre-agafen. Michdei kol abrachot kulan borei pre-agafen. So amrei bereisha. So Tosfot explained that in addition to Birkat Hamazon, the grace after meal, that you make the bracha over the wine afterwards. So he did it at the beginning. So if I do the beginning, so I can. That's the good idea to start with this. Amar borei pre-agafen. You did the bracha of borei pre-agafen ve'agid bei, and he had a length at the end of the bracha because he figured out that maybe someone started drinking from his cup. Chazila usava degachin v'shate. So he saw an elderly person that bent and started drinking from the wine. So Rav Ashi understands that even the place like Mechoza, they have the minhag to make only borei pre-agafen during the daytime, the kiddush day. So it means that they use the Rabbah, Rashbam said, for the all the Kiddushin. But the Ran and Tosfot Reed and others said that it's just the honor. It's like you said, Sagina O for someone who's blind. It's like they go the other way around. So he said, Kare Anafshe, Ravashi called upon himself what the Kohelet said, Ecclesiastic chapter 2, Hechacham Enav Berosho. So it means that someone who's smart can foresee how things turn in the future, has the ability to prophesy. So in regard to Abdallah, Amre Bnei Rabbi Chiya. So the sons of Rabbi Chiya said, Mishlo Edil Motzei Shabbat, if someone did not make Abdallah on Motzei Shabbat, Mavdil Volech Bechol HaShabbat Kulo. So he can make the Abdallah for the entire week. Ve'ad Kama, how far a person can make Abdallah. Omar Rabbi Zeira, Ad Revi'i B'Shabbat. He should make the Abdallah until the end of Tuesday, the end, meaning up to the end of Tuesday, which is beginning of the fourth day of the week, the Wednesday. Ki ha deyativ Rav Zeira kamed Rav Asi, when Rav Zeira said before Rav Asi, v'amre la Rav Asi kamed Rabbi Yochanan, it's a two-day version of what happened, v'yate v'kamar le'inyan gitin, when it's come to the tna'im, the condition of gitin, chada b'shabta u'treit lata, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, considering Batar Shabbat, it's considering 3 days after Shabbat. Because remember, when we talk about Safra the Dainei, the one who writes the Gitin needs to be very clear and specific in order to validate the Get by mentioning the exact day. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, considering after Shabbat. Arba v'chamsha u'malei yoma, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, Kamei Shabbat, they're considering before Shabbat. So if someone gave a get to his wife and he said, you are divorced by this get in condition that you give me 200 zuz, for example, after Shabbat, she's not considering a valid divorce, only if she gave him this money before the following Wednesday. So the same if he said, in condition you give me before Shabbat, it's only if she gave him before Wednesday, Thursday or Friday. That's based on Rashi Gittin 77, elaborating that. But he said, so Amar Rav Yaakov Bar Idi, Avalo Alau. So someone who make the Avdala from Sunday and onward, he have now the time until Tuesday, he should not make it over the candle, the lamp. So why? Because the Rashbam said that the whole blessing of the Borei Merah Esh, it's because it's created by Hashem at that time on Saturday night. And that's based on what we study in page 54. And then it applies solely for the time of the sunset of Motzei Shabbat, and not later during the week. If you ask me about Besamim, it's in the same school of thought, the neshama yitra, the extra soul that we have on Shabbat, and the reason we drink, we smell the besamim, it's to calm the soul down. That's applied only at that time, that Motzei Shabbat, and not for the one during the week. So therefore, if the Shulchan Aruch Or HaChaim 299 said, if it turns that someone could not make the Avdalah on time, and we do it on Sunday, etc., he can do it up to Tuesday, but he cannot make Birkat HaNer and Birkat HaBesamim. Amar Rav Bruna Amar Rav Kuvav Amud Bet 106b Hanotel Yadav Lo Yekadesh. If someone washes his hand on Friday before Kiddush, he should not make a Kiddush. He can fulfill the mitzvah by hearing someone else making the Kiddush. The Gemara said in Brachot, we study in page 52, it's called Techef Lentilat Yadayim Suda. Right after washing hand, you have to have Suda, which means you don't have to have, you're not allowed to have a hefsek between washing hand and eating. So therefore, Rav Huna teach us that if someone make a mistake and he washes his hand for the seuda, before the kiddush, he should not make the kiddush, and he should hear it from someone else. If the tzlach said, if he made a kiddush somehow by himself, so he need to wash again. V'chen amar Rav Ada bar Rava, amar Rav natal edav lo yikadesh. אמר לו רב יצחק בר שמואל בר מרתא, הקת אין עונך נפש דרב, שכחינו לשמעתי. We forget what Rav said. זימנין סגינה בקמינה קמי דרב. Many times I was standing before Rav on Friday night. זימנין דחבירה לריפתא. Sometimes he likes bread more than wine because he was hungry. Mekadesh Arifta, he made the Kiddush over the bread. Zimnin de Chaviv Alei Chamra, sometimes he likes wine better. Mekadesh HaChamra, so he make the Kiddush over the wine, which means sometimes when he preferred to make the Kiddush over the bread, so he wash, make a motzi, and he make the Kiddush over the bread. So, and he ate from the bread. So the Rashbam and the Tosfot said that that's the meaning he understand of Zochre al Yain. Anyway, so if someone ate before Kiddush or before Avdala, Amar Avuna Marav Ta'am, Eino Mekadesh. So he needs to go and make the Kiddush next day before the Seuda. The Tosfot here elaborate on that. Anyway, so they said, Ba'amina Rav Chana Bar Chinan Meravud Una, Ta'am Maushi Avdi. If someone taste before Havdala, so can he do the Havdala or he need to wait for the next day? Amar Le, Ani Omer, Ta'am Mavdil. I said he can, even though he can make Havdala, meaning that he hold leniency. V'Ravasi Amar Ta'am Eno Mavdil. So he need to wait for the next day. Rav Yirmiyah Bar Abba Ikla LeB'Ravasi. Remember what we mentioned, the opinion of Askara in the previous page. So he, Rav Yirmiyah, came to the house of Rabasi, Ishtalei V'Taimide. He forgot and he tasted something Motzei Shabbat before Abdallah. Havu Lekasa V'Abdil. They brought him a cup of wine and make Abdallah. Amar Levitu, his wife, said to him, V'Hamar Lo Avid Achi, you don't have that, so because he said, Ravasi hold that if he tastes, he should not make the Abdallah, the Rashbam explains. So Amar Le, Ravasi said, Shavkei Livim, Ke Rabbei Svirei. He said that his rabbi, his rabbi said that by force of circumstance, if he tastes, he can make Abdallah. So the Rashbam said, and Tosfot said that that's not lechatchila. Amar Rav Yosef, Amar Rav Yudah, Amar Shmuel, Ta'am Eino Mekadesh. If someone tastes food before Kiddush, he will not make a Kiddush. Ta'am before Abdallah, Eino Mavdil. Verabba Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Shmuel Ta'am Mekadesh Ta'am Mavdil. So you see here, again, two avenues, and we concluded. Gemara bring the final halacha in that sense, Kuf Zayin 107, Amar Rava Hilcheta, the halacha, Ta'am Mekadesh Ta'am Mavdil. Umi Shelo Kiddush Be'erev Shabbat, if someone could not make the Kiddush, like I told the story during the service, so a person, Mekadesh Bo'olech Kol Hayom Kulo, he can go ahead and do it the following day, in Shabbat, ad Motzei Shabbat. Mi shelo yedil Motzei Shabbat, mavdil olech kol Shabbat kulo. That opinion said up to the entire Shabbat, but Rashbam said, don't misunderstand, it's applied up to Wednesday. Which means, if there are circumstances like that, you should do it. Amema patach la'ashmat ad Rav Abaye Lishna, amar Rav Hilcheta, ta'am mekadesh, ta'am mavdil, mishlo kiddush be'erev, mekadesh bo'olech kol Hayom Kulo, mishlo yedil Motzei Shabbat, mavdil olech kol Hayom Kulo. And in this opinion, it's only Sunday until sunset, and not until Wednesday. So by halacha, we're going by the Rashbam, that up to the end of Tuesday. But according to this point, Tosfot said that it's applied only for Sunday if a person cannot make Abdallah on Saturday night. Rambam Hilchot Shabbat, chapter 29. Zochre Ol Hayayin. There is a positive mitzvah to sanctify Shabbat verbally. The sages require that one recite Kiddush over wine or bread. That's the Magid Mishneh. So that's basically based on the Pasuk. Kiddush on Shabbat day, one fulfills the obligation of Kiddush by reciting the blessing, the Bor Pri Hagafen, Shulchan Aruch 289, but we also ask what happened in a situation of a length of time. So one who forget to recite Havdalah at the conclusion of Shabbat, so may do so until the end of Tuesday afternoon, and that's the conclusion of the Rosh, and also based on that Tosfot. The Rif and the Geonim ruled that he recited Havdalah only at the end of the Sunday afternoon. So other hold that you see it by Baal Halachot Gdolot and the Tur assert that the halacha that one has already eaten may still recite Havdalah is a unique leniency for the conclusion of Shabbat. However, one who has eaten may no longer recite Havdalah at the later stage. The Rama ruled according to the first opinion. So basically, in the bottom line is up to Tuesday, for sure, only bediavad, after the fact, but not lechatchila. We also talk about the bill of divorce, and we said if one says he is to his shaliach, to his agent, write a bill of divorce for my wife after Shabbat, he means that should be written by the end of Tuesday afternoon. That's the Shulchan Aruch Ibn Ezra 144. One who recites Abdallah not immediately after the conclusion of Shabbat does not recite the blessing over the fire or species. That's Shulchan Aruch Haim 299. And the last halacha, we say that Hanotel Yadav lo yekadesh. One who washes his hand before Kiddush demonstrates that he prefers bread to wine. Consequently, the Rif said, one who does so should recite Kiddush over the bread. Based on the Rosh and the Mordechai, the Rama rules that it's preferable to wash one's hand before Kiddush and then to recite Kiddush over the wine. Several later authorities, that Shulchan Aruch Harav said, that one should act in accordance with the first opinion, and therefore one washes his hand should not recite the Kiddush. We said that one who accidentally ate before Kiddush on Shabbat night may nevertheless recite Kiddush at night, that's Shulchan Aruch HaRachaim 272, but in regard to Avdalah, one who ate before reciting Avdalah after Shabbat may still recite Avdalah. And as we said, that these are two different opinions. One said that up to Sunday without Ner and Besamim, and one should say that Bediavad up to Tuesday, and we follow the Rashbam and the Rosh and the Tosfot to go up to Tuesday late afternoon.